Hello everyone, my name is Val and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll show you my new PPT lesson, Shapes, designed for grade 3 students. But if you have strong students, it can also work in grade 2. In this ready-to-go ESL lesson, students learn to say, pronounce, and identify 6 shapes: star, oval, circle, triangle, rectangle, and square. Learn to recognize these shapes in animals and practice simple dialogue with a fun and exciting game. This PowerPoint lesson is available for sale in my stores on Teachers Pay Teachers and Shopify. If you are a PayPal user, please buy this lesson at Teachers Pay Teachers. But if you prefer using a credit card or simply want to skip the registration process, head over to my Shopify store, where you'll find an easy and streamlined shopping experience. The links to both stores are in the video description below, so you can choose what works best for you. If you enjoy my content, please like and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to turn the notifications on. This way you will never miss a single upload and help your fellow teacher grow his channel. Enjoy the walkthrough and I'll see you in my next video. Happy teaching! Bye! Let's take a good look at this PowerPoint lesson. Shapes. The first thing you want to do is you want to split your class into 2 teams. In my case, it's boys and girls. And in one of my videos, I explained why I split my class into boys and girls. But you can do it any way you want. You can split them into team A and team B, or team apple, team banana, whatever works. You know, each class is different, each school is different, each environment is different. So I do what works best in my environment, in my setting. So if you're not happy with boys versus girls, feel free to change it here, right? Then we go through class rules. Class rules are important because they set the mood, and also students know what is expected from them. So here we go. Rule number 1 is clear your desk. Rule number 2 is be quiet. Rule number 3, listen to teacher Val. Rule number 4, speak English. And rule number 5, raise your hand. Yeah, that's it. 5 rules. This slide says warm up for your class. So here you can include a warm up activity, any warm up activity you want. And also your warm up activity doesn't have to be related to this lesson. I have a lot of warm up activities on my channel. So just go to the playlist called Simple ESL Games, and there are lots of warm-up activities there. Check them out. Okay, my recommended warm-up activity would be this extra question. What day is today? So they would say today is Monday. Also, feel free to change it to the day that you are teaching, yeah? And next one is, what is the date today? And they would say, today is Monday, September the 1st, 2023. Again, here you can change it to the date that you are teaching. Then we start with new words, vocabulary, yeah? So this is where we introduce the shapes. So first they see the picture. You don't display the words. You try to listen from the students. Yeah, probably somebody already knows it. And then you show the word and you say together with the class, star. And you do the same thing with all the shapes. Oval. Yeah.
triangle, square, rectangle, and circle. There we go. What are these? Again, try to retrieve the answer from the students. If they struggle with it, you can show the answer. These are shapes. And by the way, in the square, you can write it in L1, in the student's first language, so they can see the word in their, you know, mother tongue, and then maybe it's gonna help them to say the word. So these are shapes, yeah? Now, here is the song that you might want to play in class. Here's the link. You can insert the link to the PowerPoint lesson, or you can insert the video. By the way, my members and patrons get this video right away. I've downloaded it, and I can, you know, send it to my patrons and members. It's one of the perks of being a patron or a member on my channel. Next one is the game. It's a vocabulary game, which is called Broken Telephone. So have your students split into two teams. Students line up in their teams facing the board. Show or tell the students at the back of the lines a shape, for example, square. When you say go, the students pass the word down the line by whispering it to the person in front of them. When it reaches the student at the front, they have to draw it on the board, or they can just say it. You know, whoever says it first or whoever draws it first gets a point. Yeah. This game is also called Chinese whispers. So sometimes it's called Broken Telephone, sometimes it's called Chinese Whispers. So I think it's best if you have at least four to five students in each line. But if you have a big class, let's say if you have like 30 kids or 50 kids in class, usually they sit in four rows, and like you can play this game in the aisle, you know, like between the rows, and then you can have maybe even seven or eight students in each line. Again, it depends on the size of your classroom, but it's a fun game. Students love it. I've played it many times in my classes, and it's always a win. Pop quiz. Here you introduce the question, and you also drill the word shape. And to play this quiz, to do this quiz, you invite a student from each team. You ask the question, what shape is the sun? And they need to choose the correct answer. So for example, they can say C. If they say the letter, they get a point. If they say a word, they get 2 points. Yeah, so you encourage them to say words. So it's a circle. What shape is the cookie? It is a star. And also encourage them to say full answers. Of course they can just say star, but I think it's best if they say it is a star. What shape is the egg? It's an oval. What shape is the box? It is a square. And so on, yeah? Let me go quickly through these questions. All right, now we're gonna read. Let's read. So it's a simple text here. This is a starfish. It has 5 arms. What shape is it? Again, I have included the translation. I teach in China, that's why I translate everything into Chinese. But again, it's very easy to change it into the language you are teaching, yeah? You just click on the box, and then you translate it in your language, in the first language of the students, L1. All right, so what shape is it? And if you click next here, you can see that there is a shape, and maybe this is gonna help your students, yeah? So it is a star. Next one, this is a sea turtle. It has a shell. What shape is it? It's an oval. This is a shark. It has sharp teeth. What shape is it? It is a triangle. Well done, boys and girls. This is an owl. It has a round face, or also, like, I chose the word round because, well, its face does look round, but you can also write it has a flat face. You can choose your own adjective here. What shape is it? It's a circle, yeah? And this is a boxfish. It has black spots. What shape is it? It is a square. This is a cow. It has four legs. What shape is it? It's a rectangle. There we go. Next activity is called Guess the Word. Yeah, so it's a vocabulary comprehension activity. You invite a student from each team and they have to guess the word. Whoever says it first gets a point. So here they need to say it has five arms, it has a shell, it has sharp teeth. They just need to say the word that's hidden. If they were paying attention in class, they usually this activity is no problem for them. Usually they do it very quickly. All right, so it has a round face, it has black spots, it has four legs. There we go. Next one is dialogue practice. Now look, this is for you guys, for teachers. Choose the slide that fits your student's proficiency level and then delete the rest. So I have included three slides and you choose whichever you want to use in your class. For example, this slide, here it explains what is displayed on the slide here. So this slide contains a dialogue with a translation in L1. In my case, it's Chinese, but again, you can change it into your language, right? Because I think maybe you need to explain the expression look like. It looks like a star. That's why I sometimes think it's a good idea to include the translation. But again, it depends on your student's proficiency level. Next slide has no translation. So if you don't want to include translation, just pick this slide. And the third slide contains a question and two answers. Yeah, so it has five arms. It looks like a star. I personally think this is best because we want to challenge our students a little bit. You know, if they can say two sentences, that's perfect. If they can say one, that's also good too, you know. But I think, you know, the more the better. If you challenge them a little bit, I think it works better. So this was an example, and here we go. Then you drill this together with the whole class. So you ask the question, they read the answers. Yeah? What does a shark look like? It has sharp teeth. It looks like a triangle. So this is like you drill this together with the whole class because you are kind of leading them into the final game, into the follow-up activity, which concludes the lesson. So, you go through all these questions and answers. And this is the final activity that you do in your class. It's called Snakes and Ladders. Now, I have a video on my channel which explains how to play this game. I'm going to leave a link in the description below the video, and also you can click it, click the pop-up banner in this video and watch it, how to play it. But basically, yeah, you're drilling this dialogue. What does a starfish look like? And then two answers here, yeah? So we have two teams. You can use magnets. you know, and the game objective is to get to square 16. They roll the die, and depending on the number they get, they use this animal in the question. And whoever gets to square 16 first gets 10 points. Yeah. So again, I'm not gonna talk much about this game. Just click the link and watch the video on my channel. I hope you're going to enjoy it. Well, this is it. This is it. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and this walkthrough. Happy teaching. Enjoy the lesson. Thank you.